Hello.
All right.
I wasn't ready to talk.
How about now? You ready to
now
talk?
Now I'm ready.
Okay. Everybody, please welcome Teddy Riley.
How y'all doing? I'm not going to be doing a lot. I'm letting y'all know that right now. I'm only joking. Whatever y'all need to know, I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to give you all the secrets. Why? Because like my surrogate father over here, it's always good to pass it down because that's how your legacy continues. So it's about the legacy. If you want somebody to remember you, give them your secret. So I'm ready to give y'all my secret about Prisana Studio One and how I got started with it. I got a little frustrated about just using different dials, and there was a dial that I was using. I'm not about bashing companies. I don't mention names, but there was a dial I was using, a few dials that I was using, and I wasn't happy. So I kept switching, you know, like if you don't like your car or if you don't like your sneakers, you get a new pair. So I kept switching dials until I got to the right one. And this was going on for the last 6-7 years. And I kind of dealt with the one I have, because you know, like when you're growing up and mom don't have hamburger meat or hamburger bread, you got to deal with the regular bread. You know what I'm saying? So you got to deal with what you got. So I was using what I had, what I could use. I was on one of my favorites was Logic, but that was before 6.0. So y'all know how far back that is and what year and everything. But that was the one that I did Michael Jackson and a lot of the major records like Bobby Brown. I used that and the MP. Everybody know about the MP. Those were my two favorite. That was like, you know, Law and Hardy. They were together. I used to rock out with those with a bunch of Akai's and 3000s, 900s, 2000s, and I was just stacked up with just a bunch of Akai stuff and samples and everything until we could fit it all into here. And this little box here, this three terabytes of some of my sounds. So I got tired and I kept flipping from one thing and I went from one sequencer to another, to another, and to another. And then I finally said to some of my friends, I tried this new thing, but I don't have what I want in it yet, but I'm gonna get to the company owner and I'm gonna try and get everything that I want to make this right because the learning curves were so easy for Studio One. So when I started with it, it was only, it was no key commands. It was just like a PDF with a bunch of commands that you had to learn of theirs. So I was talking to a good friend of mine. She knew the owner, Jim. And I said, I need to talk to Jim because I think he got something here. And finally, she got us on the phone. When she got us on the phone, we talked about it. And then he led me to talking to John Hillman. And me and John just started talking about everything. He said, oh, no, we got the new version. It'll be out in 2 days with the key commands. So this is how fast this company have grown from then, which is about a year and a half to now. And each month, there's always something new. Always something new, and they're changing, which is unlike the other companies. You will never get what you want in such a short period of time. You gotta wait for the next version to come. So, Yeah.
Even last year at the NAMM show with the couple of the requests for the couple keys, and 3 days later.
Oh, yeah. I mean, just when you have the perfect company to give you the perfect support and everything that you need. If something needs to be done, you would like to see something done, it could be done. You're talking about your key commands where you, if you're used to Pro Tools or you're used to Logic or you're used to Cubase, you have it here. Your same key commands, everything is the same. There's nothing different. The editing curves, amazing. But when you want to bang out, this is the place to bang out. Because you're able to go from one thing, one idea to another so quick and fast like that. So what I'm going to do today is something kind of crazy. I'm going to do, I think, 2, 3, 4 tracks in one without stopping. I'm going to slow it down. I'm putting loops in here at the same time. So I'm going to do a fast track. No, let's start off with a dubstep track. I'm going to do a dubstep, just mess around with something. Then I'm going to speed it up, make a club track. Then I'm going to slow it down and make a ballad. And I'm never going to stop the machine. Just to show you how you're able to go from one idea to another, and it'll be right in your head. You can have something else. You had an idea for something else, you can actually do it. But you don't have to stop. You can just keep going. So
we
want to
talk about important sounds and samples and start there.
Yeah.
Pull in some sounds.
Yeah. Let's do it. So let's go through the access to everything. On this side here, which is
over there, here, the browser.
Right here. This is your life when you're in this DAW. This is your life. You're going from, this is the house. You have your instruments, you have your effects, you have your sounds, files, and you have your pull. So if I start off with an instrument, I can actually bring an instrument in. Separates us from the effects, all of my effects, right? Then we have the sounds from Presonus, which is you got your starter kit. So if you don't have anything, you got some sounds. When you get this software, you got your starter kit. And the starter kit is not corny. It's a starter kit with sounds from all of us, all of the people who contribute to the Presonus family, the Presonus team, my man here, Byron. We all have sounds in here. Favorite sounds, sounds that hit hard. So you're able to use this, and then we go into my sounds. So we're pretty loaded. I kind of separated. What you see here is a tab at the top where I kind of name all of the different sounds that I have. Another thing that I have, let's put this, center it. There we go. Another thing I have is a search engine. So when I want to search something, I can go here and I can say, I want to search snares. All my snares. So it never stops. Snares, snares, snares for days. You can never not have enough snares. Right? But I don't want to have snares. I want to go for kicks. Here's kicks. Kicks for days. So you have your search engine. You can search anything. Anything you're looking for, you can search, and you can audition them. So I'm sorry, I don't have this up. I started talking real fast, and I got to turn up the sound. Let's see if we run it here. So you can audition them, just go up and down, and it's pretty fast. You don't have to wait for anything. And it's coming from this hard drive, so everything is real time. So I'm just going with it. Now, the access to that, what you're using that for is like when you have one of the drum machines. Now, I use their drum machine a lot. I use the Impact, because it's so fast to get to, just pull it up. It's right there. Everything is drag and drop. So I'll go back to my files, and I can just. Now let me get this running.
It's up?
Yeah.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Okay. All right. So I'm going to start this keyboard up. All right. So let's back to what I was saying. You can pretty much access the kicks and bring things in. So if I like this kick, I just bring it in. And so I'm bringing my kick in, and I'll go back for my snares. And I want to access snares. I'll put it there. All right, so that's what the actual Impact do for you. I use that because it's fast. With Studio One, I can get to it easy. I can bring up some drums really quick, and you can pull up
any file you drag in there, right? Any audio file, it doesn't matter. From here, wherever you throw it into Impact,
right? And it's also time stretched. This drum machine is actually time stretched. So if you have a hi-hat that is short, and that open hi-hat is something that you want it to be long, you can take that hi-hat and make it longer. So let's go and pull up. Let's pull up hats. So say I like that hi-hat, and I want it, but I want the hi-hat to be short. I can make that hi-hat. Is even longer, or I can make it tremendously short. No, this is making it long. So it's shorter. And I can make it even shorter. But you still hear it the same.
It's not changing the tone.
It's not even changing the tone. So there you have it. Where this drum machine, if you want something longer or if you want it in reverse, you can pretty much do that. And that's what the search engine do for you. You can actually bring anything into your drum machine, or you can even bring it into the sampler. So say if I bring a loop and I want just any loop. But I like that loop. I don't want to bring it in as a loop. I want to bring it in just as a sample. You can actually bring it into one of the samplers and play it. Wow. So, what's that?
All inputs.
Oh, that's right. I'm sorry. So my all. So I want to bring it in. And it's into the sample. So I can bring it in, and it's right there at my access. Or if I like it just the way it is, I could just bring it up and pull it right here. And it's there. I'll just loop it. I'll take it and glue it together. You have one loop. I can reverse it. Oh, that's normalizing it. Oh. All right, so I can reverse it. So pretty much, I can do anything to a sample. I do a lot of my sound designing in here just to make my sounds. I'll design it in here, and then that's my loop. And I create songs from doing that. So.
Show artillery.
What's that?
Start running artillery on it?
We're going to do that. That's going to be at the end.
I
That's the end. I want to give them that at the end. So ask me anything. Anybody have questions?
Talking about being able to drag effects from track to track and
what's that?
Talk about dragging effects from track to track and things that you like to do.
Oh, yeah. The fun things that you can't do with the other ones. Well, let's just bring up a bunch of things. I'm going to bring up a demo. Let's close this down. Matter of fact, no. We don't have to close it down. We can go here.
You can bring up as many songs as you want.
10, and go from one song 11, to another to another to another.
15.
So here I have a bunch of stuff, but I want to start getting rid of things. Let's get rid of this. All right. And I want to start with let's solo one thing. So I want to bring an effect in on that. I want that effect to be something to make this hit even harder. So I'm gonna bring in transit. You bring it and you drag it on the track. So now, So, do y'all hear the attack on that kick and that snare? So, I like the way that sounds, so I wanna bring up the drum machine. I want to add a kick and snare. I want to add just a whole kit. So I'm going in here. Still, you're going up. We're going off the loop. So I'm bringing in the impact. And I'm going to go and bring up just a kit. So on this kit, I have my kick. I got to bring my, let's go here. Put it on all. So that's just the kick beer. Now I can separate each track on here, and every time I separate it, I don't have to go into the environment to actually separate it in the mixer. It separates automatically. So I'm gonna separate each instrument, and then I'm gonna start adding effects to it. So now when I bring up the mixer, let's get rid of this. And let's get rid of the drum machine for a minute. And let's take a lot of this stuff down so you don't have to see anything but just the actual mixer. So what I have here is the actual drum machine.
So you see each channel separated.
Everything is separated. I didn't have to go in like you have to go into the other dials and do the environment and change everything up. It's pretty much there at the action. So now I want to add that same effect that you've seen I put on the, I want to take that same effect, put it here, right? Now, this is one of my secrets, y'all. So, so I like the way that sound, right? If I like the way that sound, I want to take it and put it to the snare too. And I want to take it and put it here. You don't have to hold something like option and move it. You put effect on anything. So I'm taking that, put it here as well. I'm gonna put it here as well. So my effect is on everything. It's making everything snap. So now, that's the trick with using your effects, and you can drag it to everywhere. You can use it for anything, and say if I like what I put on my effects, I can take that effect and save it. Because I like it, I can save that effect and that whole chain. So if you got a whole bunch of effects and you got it on one thing or a vocalist, you can actually save that chain. So everything here is drag, drop, save, you got it forever. Hey, everybody following me?
Talk about, you know, when you have a thought, when you have an idea of something you want to do, you know, if it takes you 30 seconds to attach whatever it is you need to get it, the idea might be gone. Whereas here, you think of it and you're doing it.
First of all, everybody know here, if you're a musician, you're a creator, your attention span is this small, like a little kid. So if you don't get what you're supposed to get right now, you lose the idea. It's gone. You're on to the next. So if you got an idea right then and there, you want to be able to get to it really quick and program it. And that's what this do. So when I have an idea, just like what I'm going to show you all, going from one song into another, but I have another song on my mind, a ballad, but I'm not stopping my sequencer. Everything is still going. I don't never have to stop. So I'll show you that in a minute. I know my time is almost up, but I hope. All right. Okay.
Some of the other stuff we were talking about. You mentioned a couple of things already. We did the dragging the tracks from effects from track to track. We talked about how responsive the programming guys in Germany are. They hook you up quick when you got a request. The search engine, and you're showing the sample one and impact drag and drop. So,
Well, here's the other thing I want you all to know, that this machine, say if you're not happy with something at the end of a song or a track, you're not happy with the tempo.
Oh, right. Yeah.
You're easy to time stretch, and it would not change the sound of your music or your production. So you can actually speed it up. You can slow it down, which I will show you. When I do this, I'm going to be able to speed it up, slow it down to a ballad, take the tracks that I've been working on, put it in a folder, and put it away. So I can hide those tracks and go for another song. So I'm going to do that. And then that'll be my time. All right, so let's go for it. I'm going to start with the dubstep, all right? So we'll start here. I started with this just to kind of, I was messing around with this in the actual room just to put something up, just to show you how this works. So these are all loops that I grabbed in. Let's get rid of that. And let's get rid of that. So you can see the actual whole 8-bar. So as you know, I can speed up, I can slow down, I can say I want it at, still the same. Y'all hear a difference? Anybody hear a difference? So I'm gonna start adding, I'm gonna add my hi-hat. And these are all just loops. Now, the one thing with this software is you never get writer's block, because everything can start however you want it to start. You can start with just drums. You can start with just keyboards if you get an idea. You can go around that. Or you can start with just vocals. Or you can just start with a loop. So you got loops for years.
Didn't you, when you did the Michael Jackson song, you started with vocals?
Yes. When I was brought into the Michael Jackson project, they gave me a whole bunch of tracks that I had to figure all out. First of all, the first thing I had to figure out was the tempo. I had to figure out where we were at on that. Then I had to figure out the vocals. I had to clean the vocals. I had to do so many things, but at the same time, I still got to create the track. Now, whether they're happy or not, or I'm happy with the track, I wasn't happy with a lot of things, and I would produce 5 different remixes for one song. So I can do that in here, and I'm dealing with, what, about 70 tracks? So this here will not trip. It's 64-bit. It depends on the speed of your computer. You can do pretty much anything you want. So with this, well, I had my bigger towel, but I did a lot of things out of my laptop because I was in a room while the big towel was going with the mixer. So we had to do things like a team. They were mixing on the big machine. I'm here programming on the small machine. So this is what I'm using. Same exact machine, 16 gig of RAM, 64-bit, and we're at 2.0 gigahertz. So it's just enough for me to do what I need to do and still deal with all the tracks that they're giving me. Now you're talking about a 5-minute song, and you gotta speed it up, slow it down, so it really depends on the speed of your computer, whether that can happen fast or slow. And most of the time, I want things to happen fast. I'm sure everybody else do too, because that's our attention span.
Which is, and Studio
very
One,
short.
Studio One being new, fresh code, you can move faster than you can in the other programs.
Exactly. So that's what I did. So I'm actually gonna just start while I'm talking to you all, and if you all have questions, I'll point, they'll turn down the music, you ask the question, I answer them, and I go back to what I'm doing. All right? So you want to crank me up? So with this track, I'm creating some crazy stuff here, and it's still loops going. I want to go and I want to add an effect just to kind of make everybody think that this is a real dubstep track. So I want to mess around with gross beats. Now, with this, I won't be able to do anything unless I take the pointer and do it with my hand. But no, I don't want to do that. I want to go in and manipulate it myself. I want to add a track. And I want to be able to manipulate the gross beats. So I'm here. Yes, you know. Thank you so much. All right, so I'm taking my little machine. I'm going to create a little remix here. So what I'm doing here, I'm able to do and record it. So. What you see here. All right, I'm gonna record that. So, here it is. Give me a count. 3, 4. So it's now doing it for me. Am I losing sound? Oh, no, no, I'm not. I'm sorry. So now I have that going. Now I want to add more instruments. I want to add more loops. I just want to add some crazy stuff. And then I'm going to go to another song. So I'm going from this to an up-tempo. I'm going to give you a club, four on the floor, crazy stuff. And I'm going to program with it, kick, snares, and some crazy stuff on top of it with my little keyboard, and this is how I do this on the plane. So let's start it again. Bringing in all loops, just crazy stuff. Yeah. one thing you can also do, and you see I have all of these highlighted, but I want to time stretch them so that that breather, that breath can come even faster. So I'm taking it, and I'm going like that, and I just time stretched it. So it's... Let's take this off for a minute. Now, do y'all hear the breather? So I can actually slow it or speed it up a little if it's too much or if it's too slow. See what I'm doing? Or? So I'm doing them all. And it's too fast. Now, so you're able to time stretch on the spot. You're able to do pretty much anything that you want. So, now, I want to bring in some, oh, let's bring in a whole thing. Get my drums. Oh no, I am not even in the drum machine. Let me stop, y'all. Let me get back to the top and let's add a drum machine. And let's get a sound up. I haven't stopped yet, did I? I'm still going, right? All right. Oh, my default. My fault. All right. All right. slowed it down, right? So I like this little bit right here. So I want to start cutting. Glue it together. Bring on my step control, which I didn't show y'all. Step control, take it, and I want to sync everything together. Still want to use some of the stuff that I have. Notes. because this is hot. Like, you can make beats just out of the effects alone and create crazy stuff. So what I'm gonna bring up here, all right, let's bring it into my master. What I'm doing is I'm bringing it into the master, but you're able to also put it on the separate track. So I could put an effect on that track and manipulate it, or I could put it on a whole master and manipulate it. So I'm putting it on the master. I'm gonna put it right under Gross Beats. And I'm gonna bring up. All right. Let's take that, throw it away. Let's get out of here. I'm gonna actually manipulate the artillery. So I'm gonna record that. Another one, which is the Gross Beat. What I just did is create it, and I don't like the speed. So I want to slow it down. 20. So I'm actually doing, I can add bass to this, I can add snare, and it's going to do exactly what that is doing. So just to give you an example of what it would do, and what it can do, I'll bring in an instrument. We'll be right back. seen how you can pretty much get into your own world.
Let's hear it.
And just by
doing it. We got also like hundreds of people watching on the, around the world on the web. And we're getting some questions coming in, like as far as the sound of this DAW.
Okay.
Let's talk about
The sound of it, it's what you make it. And only go, like analog tape, go by what you hear. If it doesn't distort you, that's what it is on this DAW. I don't know about any of the other DAWs, because you can get tricked by it. One of them mainly, you think you got it at a nice level, and then next thing you know, you take it to somewhere else and it's distorting. This here, you're not gonna get that. You're not gonna get it, it's what you hear, and that's the thing about Studio One, Studio One 2. You're not gonna get no distortion if you don't hear it right here. When you're mixing it, it's what you mix, it's what you hear, and if it's loud, hitting the peak, don't be afraid. With this DAW, you don't have to be afraid of taking it to the peak. You can go +6, you can go +8.
What
you understand? Rig,
this setup you got here, describe what you got, what power just, as far as the laptop and...
I just got, this is an extra piece because I like the trackball. I'm a trackball, vintage trackball user. So I like the trackball. I have a bigger setup just for my laptop, which gives me 24 channels. But when I'm traveling, I take my little audio box, which gives me 2 channels when I just want to bang out or go to a studio and just crank it. I take this. This is 3 terabytes. If you got sounds and it's like taking luggage, you gotta have that extra space for more sounds because you may go somewhere else and pick up more sounds. You know, I think we all like, when we used to trade baseball cards, I give my friends sounds, they give me sounds. It's like trading baseball cards. So I always have extra space in here for people like Byron, you know, who will give me sounds, and John will give me sounds. I'll go, you know, so I'll have like 2 of these just sitting, but you can link them. I have my my license keys here for all of my VST instruments that I have licensed, and some they don't need them. But pretty much I have everything that I need right here, and I travel with it, with this one thing.
And you don't run into any problem with track count, and
no.
You're just going crazy, right?
You see how it's just going, and I can keep going, and just once I got what I want, I can go to another 8 bars and create something else, and another 8 bars and just put it all together, and that's my song. I mean, you all know pretty much how to do that, but like I said, don't be afraid with this to pump and hit hard. It's just like tape. It's just like tape. If you hear it distorting in the tape, you're not going to push it. It's just like this, the same thing. And it's pretty fast. I mean, y'all can see it. It's pretty fast, access, user-friendly, and it's ready to go. Drag, drop, and you got everything pretty much here. Once you save it once, it's saved forever. So, questions? Yes, I have vocals in here as well. I do it straight here. I do all of my vocoder stuff in my bedroom. And I pretty much have big boom mic. I do everything right in here. And I plug right in here. I don't even use a preamp. I plug right there.
And the audio box.
And this is affordable, y'all.
Because to tell them, also, all of our interfaces.
Carry it in your bag.
Have the same mic pre in the VSL-22 that's in the 24-channel mixer.
Yes.
Across the line, it's the same mic pre.
And then, at the same time, it has also a separate, the VSL has a separate mixer from the DAW that you can plug your mic in and you have no latency.
Yeah, the driver for the VSL is written at the core level. 8 samples, 2 milliseconds round trip.
That's right.
Zero latency.
And that's... pretty much no latency.
For $1.99.
You know, you ain't gonna notice that. So, anybody else?
Uploading to SoundCloud. Did you just use that feature?
Uploading to SoundCloud.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
That's what I want to know.
All right, I want to show you something. This is what I do all the time. I have my SoundCloud. Everybody know about SoundCloud, right? So I got my SoundCloud here. Do we have the internet here?
Oh, but you might not be in
I may not be able to get it, right?
Well, if you didn't say go in, but it.
I need you, brother. That song. All right. You know which one? Rain.
Yeah, well, he's hooking rain. Him up to the internet right now. There's
Rain, rain. Go away. Come back another day. You don't even know your own song. I don't want to even tell him your name. I don't even want to tell him who you are. You don't even know your own song.
Hey, Teddy.
Uh-huh.
And also tell him about like an app like iMachine.
Oh,
which,
yes.
Which is another app where we were talking about this when we're doing the Melodyne stuff. That
so
you can
this here,
sing into your
it's
phone.
It's on here.
Yeah.
So you can bring up your own SoundCloud within here and drag and drop.
Shows up in the browser.
Shows up in the browser. You can drag it and drop it. And it's a different, which we're working on that right now yeah. for the, where you can drag the actual SoundCloud file into the DAW. You know what I'm saying? Because it's a different, oh, it does?
No, we got it in the browser. It's
It works.
In iMachine.
See how fast things work here? It got it working right now. Yeah, and drag it right in. So it works, but when we, that's it. So, pretty much what you got in your SoundCloud, if you got an idea, you never lose that idea. You just do it right there and just hum it, bring it right in here. But at the same time, you can hum it, bring it in.
We ain't even talking about Melodyne.
And you take it and you Melodyne it and put it in key. So it integrates with Melodyne where any idea that you have, sing it as close as you want or as close as you can. And you bring it into here and, I'm sorry, and you can Melodyne it, and then you can have it manipulate a synthesizer
MIDI
sound.
File, right. You make a
MIDI
file,
and it'll play a bass track or whatever. So that's how far you can go with this. So any other questions? Y'all believers? I have a lot of people that switch to this program because you know, they're able to do pretty much anything that they want to do, and it's at their access.
And it's a cross-platform program, Mac or PC.
Mac or PC.
Use it whatever
so
you want.
We're not discriminating. It works. I have to say this, y'all. I'm a PC guy. You put me on the spot.
Kicks
I'm a
ass
PC
on the Mac.
Guy. But it works better on Mac. I'm going to tell you this. It works better on Mac. Even with 4 gigs of, gig of RAM, it works better on Mac because PC, as you know, is what you make it. Now, my PC, you ain't see me, it didn't go down. So my PC is right, but I don't want you to get home and be like, yo, this joint worked in, at the convention center.
Why isn't my Dell kicking it?
Why my PC ain't working with it, you know? You know how you get to a store and something work at the store and then you get it at home and it don't work. I don't want to put y'all in that position. So get... You know, go get a Mac if y'all want to get a Mac. I don't care. I just like PC because I got some plugins here that y'all can't mess with. And y'all can't get it because they ain't going to make it for the Mac. Y'all, this one, the one, you ain't going to be able to get it. The Gross Beats? Did you hear it? You sure you heard it? You ain't just get here. I ain't see you over here when I seen him. Nah, I'm only messing with you. Everybody, that's Mike City. I want to acknowledge a lot of people out here. I have a lot of people here that used to play in my band or, you know, we actually jammed many times before.
Tell me you got the new record coming out.
What's that?
Tell me you got the new record coming out, too.
The new Blackstreet album. How about the new Guy album? I got a better response on Blackstreet. So Blackstreet won. We got Blackstreet coming first. And, you know, I'm not going to.
Tour.
Anything is possible. You make it a Guy album. You know, if we can put it together, it's going to happen. I want to give people what they want as far as music is concerned because they deserve it. You know, y'all supported the music that I've done for so many years. So I'm starting with Blackstreet this year. We have a TV show coming, which is The Life of Riley. And it's basically my life story and things that you don't know that I've done, and music that I've done that you never thought.
Glad you said music.
Yeah, music, yeah. Whoa. Yeah. Music. But those are that's what the actual show is about, and it's just talking about the things and people that I work with, and from the beginning, how I started and where I'm at now, and going into the major TV show, which you guys will enjoy because you enjoy music in the past and artists from the past. You're going to enjoy hearing artists from the past with this new TV show that we have. It's like the next X Factor. And it's called Encore. So get ready for it. You'll see artists like Terrence Trindabi, Lisa Stanfield. Then you'll see The Emotions, Earth, Wind, and Fire as guests because they made a slew of hits. But the artists that you haven't seen in a long time that you want to see, they deserve an encore. So that's what the show is about. So any other questions? I'm like talking. Say that one more time. I'm sorry.
He's asking if he can bring sounds that you've used from other programs.
From
that
other
you've
programs?
Used
and yeah. And yes. Yes. There's a sample in here, and also they have converters where you can convert your Logic EXS sounds to pretty much anything, and play them right in here. You can bring in Logic songs. You can bring in Cubase songs. And you could just bring in files. You could just drag and drop all your files and put them up. They timestamp in Pro Tools. They'll actually come into here, timestamp.
We got one more question back here. All right, let's start in the corner.
What's that?
Rex Files? Loves Rex Files.
All right, let me show you what I could do with Rex Files. All right, let's pull up another song. Let's pull up this here, and say if I go in here and I'm looking at, let's go to the Rex folder, and let's say these are Rex, huh? Now check it out. You see my Rex? I'm previewing. All right. Now, let's bring up my impact, which is here, bam. And I want to go to an empty. And let's go back to that file. And let's say we want to start with this. And we want to take that there. And we want to drag it. We dragged it to the drum machine.
You see what he just did, right?
You didn't know that, and I gave you this a long time ago. That means you didn't spend time with it. You got to spend time with it. And it's right here. All right, let's go back to, let's go here. This is. All right, so there you have it.
Every file format you can think
anything
of, Rex files, acid
Rex,
files,
anything.
Apple loops.
You can bring it in to this and play it. Right then and there, so, it plays the Rex file.
All your sound libraries you've been collecting for years, you can use them in Studio One.
And now, sound designing. You can also sound design just like how you do Recycle. We have Transit Beat Detector. And you can do the same thing and turn it into a Rex file. And, you know, I do sound design in here all the time. I'll spend a day just sound designing inside here, just creating a sound that, you know, it's not a stock sound. So I want to get away from stock sounds. So you can do your sound creating in here, right in the DAW. Don't just use it as a sequencer. Use it as a sound designer as well.
Hey,
you can.
You could talk about like we were doing last night, where you take any sound, pull it into a track. And maybe there's
and
a noise or something at the end of the thing.
Yes.
And we just peel it back and put a little crossfade and then drag it into impact. And
exactly.
Now it's a cleaned up sound. And it takes 2 seconds.
anything you can do on the fly, right then and there. If you have an idea, you can do it right there. With a sound design, you can take things, reverse it, do crazy stuff with it on the spot. Any other questions?
Let's give it up for Teddy Riley, everybody.